could do great things. It is not by power, it is not by might, but he said by my spirit. Wherever the spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. There will be liberty. There will be jubilee. There will be deliverance. There will be healing. There will be miracles. There will be breakthroughs in the midst of us. Yesterday, whilst Pastor was ministering, very powerful, powerful way,
yes.
Powerful way.
Yes.
I told you that he was just finishing with the preparation of the cake. My work is just to come and place the icing on the cake so that it will taste sweeter. He said something, I thank God, he said that in the kingdom and in the presence, there are different faces. Some faces are just slow. Some faces are just boyo. Some faces are just crack, 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 crack. And the face of Pastor was that when Pastor was ministering, he was ministering in our local dialect and he was feeling comfortable and he was enjoying it. But I'm also a different face within the kingdom of God. The face, though I am coming, I am one of your own. Though I am just like you, I am coming from the Ashanti part of Ghana. And yet, if I try to minister in tea, it is going to be disaster. So see me as one of the faces in the kingdom and leave me alone so that I can be a blessing unto you. You've come to be blessed. You've not come to the school of linguistics. You've come to receive from above. You've come to receive from Jehovah. You've come to receive your blessings. You've come to receive your miracle. And that is what you must care for. Don't think of this young man. Why the English, English, and English? Whether you like it or not, that is how God has made me. I am one of the faces. I am one of your brothers in the kingdom. Accept me. Hallelujah. God is taking us to the place of abundance. Church. What I saw about you last night is awesome.
Amen.
I've been ministering by the special grace of the Almighty God. God has taken me to places. I don't take credit. Everything is minus me. It's all about Jesus Christ.
Amen.
He must increase always and we must decrease.
Amen.
We will still choose to be a servant irrespective of everything that God will do with us. We are just vessels. But what I'm saying is that I've been to places and everywhere that I go, as God brings me alongside with ministers, because nowadays the kingdom is dangerous in the kingdom. So I choose to go on my knees and pray about such a minister in the church. Everywhere I go, God, I see things. But the things that God has just caused this eye to behold concerning this man is awesome.
Amen.
You are at the right place.
Amen.
At the right time,
amen.
For the right person,
amen.
For the right messages,
amen.
For the right anointing,
amen.
For the right blessings, and you are on your way to heaven.
Amen.
That must be your focus.
Amen.
And God said that I am taking my people to another level. I am taking them to the place of abundance. I am taking them to where they have never been before. Something that you've never experienced in your life is about to happen.
Amen.
Some blessings, some victories, some breakthroughs that you've never beheld with these eyes of yours. God is about to expose you to those things.
Amen.
But God said that, son, prepare ye the way of the people. My son started, but continue from where he left, so that the spirit and the hearts of the people will be together with you. So that by the time that we will be coming to tomorrow and Sunday and on Tuesday, we will just be soaring on the wings of eagle. Because it is written in the volumes of the book that they that wait upon the Lord, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagle. They will run and not be weary. They will walk and not faint. The Bible says, even as we receive our wings like eagle, we will fly above the currents of the earth, the currents of the situations and circumstances. We will rise above sickness. We will rise above poverty. We will rise above joblessness. People, listen to me. Listen to me. There is coming a great revival.
Amen.
In the country of Italy.
Amen.
And that revival is not just a revival of souls coming to God, but revival of jobs and revival of people. Listen to me. This thing has been in my spirit. Let me just release it and I'll be free. There is coming a great tidal wave. I don't know whether you've done geography before. Tidal wave is boisterous, is dangerous. You can't stop that current. If you try to stop it, it will kill you.
Amen.
But God said that before my people can get to where I'm taking them to, they must be able to understand and know my will. Before you come to every kingdom, when you talk about kingdom, there are two compound words: kingdom, a king and his domain, or a king and his place of operation or territory. Every king must have subjects, and if the subjects are going to enjoy the goodness of that kingdom, they must also be able to understand the will of the king. Is that right? Okay, I'm in the right place. So he said that I am taking my people, believe you me, by the time that we'll be drawing the curtains down concerning this meeting, you will have the cause to come and so some people will come and greet you, that pastor, thank you for organizing such a meeting. The will of God is very important. Before you can enjoy that blessing of yours, before you can receive that breakthroughs, before you can come to the place of abundance, and before you can just have access to the goodness and the mercies and the blessings within the kingdom of God, you must also as well understand the will of the kingdom.
Amen.
It is one thing for you to know the will of God, and it's another thing for you to do the will of God.
Amen.
The Bible says in Acts chapter 1, Jesus began to do and touch the word of God. He did the word of God before he touched the people. So here, I know that this gathering is unto Jesus. Please listen to me. It will be better for you to get all the children inside. Let somebody be overseer over them. There shouldn't be any movements. There shouldn't be any distraction from children or whatsoever. Because this thing is in my... I need to download it to you.
Amen.
You need to get every bit of what is coming to you, people. No, nothing should distract you. And in these gatherings like this, don't wait until the man of God finishes and calls you and begin to speak into your life. Because those dispensations are past and gone. We are living in the apostolic dispensation, whereby even as we are preaching, we are prophesying. Because the Bible says in Revelation chapter 19 verse 10, the Bible says that the testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. Testimony is something that speaks of something or somebody. So the testimony, the testament, the Old Testament and the New Testament, the Old Testimony of Jesus and the New Testimony. The Old Testament is the shadow of the New Testament. So even as I am preaching like this to you, I am prophesying to you. So anywhere when God says something and that thing into your situation, you better receive it and shout with joy and say, Lord, this is my portion. And in Ghana, where I'm coming from, when the preaching is going on and the thing hits you like this, the offering boy is there, you go and then drop something there, you sow into the word, it is fine. You can't buy the word of God, but you can have access to the word. The will. When we talk about the will, people, you got to understand, we have four different kinds of wills. Number one is the will of man. You have your own will as a human being. Human being in theology, there's something that we call in theology, that every human being is a tripartite. When you talk about tripartite or dichotomy, it all speaks about as a human being, you are made up of three components. You are a spirit, you have a soul, and you live in a body. The soul, when you talk about the soul also comprises in three dimensions. When you talk about the soul, you are talking about the will, the emotions, and the intellect. The intellect has nothing to do with your mindset, the way you are brought up. That is why the Bible says in Romans chapter 12 verse 1 and 2, he says that, beloved, I beseech you therefore by the mercies of God, that do not conform to the patterns of this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. Don't conform, but be transformed. which implies that before you came to this church, before you came to this meeting, you have your own ideas, you have your own thoughts, you have your own thinking, you have your own way of assessing things.